that we've done all through this month of February.
In memorial of the time of Jesus Christ and how Jesus himself now became the New Testament Passover. Taking the body and the blood of Jesus Christ is a sign that we are part of the Lord, and we are remembering that Jesus shed his blood for us and he crucified his body for us, that we might be reconciled back to God eternally. This is a remember, and it has to be done in a worthy manner. If you are in sin, you can come, you can't come to take this body and the blood of Jesus Christ. And we, the Lord Jesus said, we should continue to do this in his remembrance, declaring the death of our Lord Jesus Christ till he comes. So that is to say that Jesus is still coming back. So we have to continue as much as we can do it in remembrance of our Lord Jesus Christ, which has to be done in a very humbly manner in the name of Jesus. And now we want to go further conclusively this month about this blood of Jesus. What are the importance, the significance of the blood of Jesus? What does the blood of Jesus do for us? Do we really know the importance, the security, the effectiveness of the blood of Jesus? And how do we go about the blood of Jesus and the body of Christ? The first of all, it remits sins. The blood of Jesus remits sins. According to Matthew chapter 26, verse 28, the blood of Jesus remits sins. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus also gives life to those who consume it. By the time you take the communion, according to your faith, when you take the body and the blood of Jesus in faith, according to John chapter 6, verse 58-53, I'd love to read that bit of the Lord. It brings vitality back to our bones. Vitality, I'm a living testimony of that. When you are terribly sick and you have your faith, you take the body of Christ and the blood of Jesus. It brought restoration to your bones, to your blood. It gives life back to you. According to John chapter 6, verse 53, it says, then Jesus said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, except ye eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, ye have no life in you. The blood and the body of Jesus Christ brings life. That is why you see testimonies, someone that is dead, someone that is sick, critically sick, takes the body of Jesus and the blood of Jesus Christ, and is totally restored back to life because of the life in the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus also causes us to dwell in Christ and eat in us. Hallelujah. In time, you take the body of Christ. In time, you take the blood of Jesus Christ. Makes us abide with him. It helps us not to go astray. It makes us not be established in God. John 6 verse 56 says, he that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me and I in him. It brings back a kind of a union. It brings back a kind of bonding within us and God, Jesus Christ. It makes us get bonded with God. It makes us get established in God. Body and the blood of Jesus Christ causes us to dwell in Christ Jesus. It makes us unshakable and unmovable in the name of Jesus. Also, another significance of the blood and the body of Jesus Christ is that it means which Jesus Christ becomes our atonement through faith. Jesus Christ became atonement and sacrifice for us because to be restored back to God. According to Romans chapter 3, verse 25, we are looking at the conclusive part of the Passover covenant, the significance of the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. But we get to know, Roman, please put it down a little bit. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus' blood and flesh became the new Testament Passover. So in time, as a Christian, we take communion. communion, we take the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. It justifies us and saves us from wrath of God. Romans chapter 5, verse 9. I wish we can have all time to read all this Bible verse. Romans chapter 5, verse 9. We are justified by his blood. So it's only if we can believe and be baptized, we are already justified by the blood of Jesus. We shall be saved from wrath through him. We are talking about the significance of the blood of Jesus and the body of Christ. Passover covenant. Jesus Christ became the New Testament Passover. And that is why Jesus Christ said, each time we take the communion, the body and the blood of Jesus Christ, we are doing that in remembrance of him. And we are looking through today the significance, the importance of communion, the importance of blood and the body of Christ. It redeems us. According to Ephesians chapter 1 verse 7, what is that chapter 1 verse 18 to 19? Revelation chapter 5. Verse, chapter 5 verse 9. The blood of Jesus and the body of Christ brings those who were far away from God near to him. Hallelujah. It brings those who were far away from God near to him. It grants us the forgiveness of sin. According to Colossians 1 chapter 14. It brings peace and reconciliation to God. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus and the body of Christ, it makes us obtain eternal redemption unto us. Amen. There are lots of benefits of the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. The death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. It cleanses our conscience from dead works to serve the living God. Hallelujah. It cleanses us from all dead works so that we will be able to be free. It liberated us to have freedom to serve Jesus, the God. Just like the blood of the Passover gave the Israelites the freedom to be able to get out of every dead works of the Egyptians. And they came to Canaan land and they began to serve the Lord. So likewise the blood of Jesus and the body of Christ that was shed on the cross of Calvary. It cleansed us from every dead works. And we are liberated to be able to serve God, the living God, with all freedom. No wonder it says in the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. Also, it is the means by which we enter the most holy place with boldness. Hallelujah. By the grace of God, the body and the blood of Jesus Christ, allow us to come boldly to the throne of grace, to come with boldness, to ask for mercy, grace. Hallelujah. In time of need. Hebrews chapter 4 verses 15 and 16. It says, for we have not an high priest which cannot be touched, amen, with the feelings of infirmity, but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Jesus. The blood of Jesus also speaks better things. The blood of Jesus speaks better things than the blood of Abel. So another thing that the blood of Jesus can speak. So when you are praying and you cannot even speak for yourself, you call upon the blood of Jesus to speak for you. In a court case where people are judging you, where you have already been condemned, when you key into this revelation of Hebrews chapter 12 verse 24, and you tell God that the blood of God speaks, the blood of God can speak, it's God's mouth to speak, it speaketh better things, it's as it satisfies, so likewise it speaks. So the blood of God can liberate, can speak on our behalf, wherever we have been condemned or judged. The blood of God sanctifies us. Every impurity, every demonic oppression, the blood of God sets us free. Hebrews 13 verse 12.
12.